Frosted cereal originated in America in the 1950s, and today you'll find versions of it on breakfast tables around the world. It's one of the first things some people reach for in the morning. This particular blend of frosted cereal is a combination of wheat flakes, corn flakes, and granola clusters. Half the flakes are frosted and half aren't. And there's honey, rolled oats, and rice in the granola. To make the corn flakes, they start with kernels of corn. They measure out a specific amount and release it into an industrial version of a pressure cooker. The operator locks the lid and the system pipes water and flavorings directly into the cooker. It rotates for an even distribution of heat and an even cooking of the grains. After about 3 hours, the kernels have absorbed moisture and softened. As the corn flows out of the cooker, a screw conveyor system moves it towards a dryer. They cook a measured amount of whole wheat kernels in water and flavorings. They only need an hour in the rotating pressure cooker. Like the corn, the whole wheat absorbs a significant amount of water during cooking. The kernels are about 30% moisture when they exit the cooker. They now merge with the corn en route to the dryer. The drying time will bring the moisture content down to about 19%, making the kernels the right consistency to be transformed into flakes. The grains now flow into a mill. The mill has two big heavy rollers, similar to the kind used to level tarmac. The kernels fall between these rollers, and they exert tons of pressure to flatten each individual kernel into a flake. In the process, the wheat flakes turn whiter and the corn turn more yellow. At this point, the flakes are still quite soft and not at all tasty. A trip through a long toaster oven will give it that crisp cereal consistency. It's a high temperature toasting and reduces the moisture content from 19% to just 3%. Here, you can see the flakes before toasting and after. The toasting not only makes the corn and wheat flakes crispy, it also enhances the color and flavor. A ride on a conveyor cools them down. Along the way, they split into two different streams. One stream of the mixed flakes travels towards the sugar coating station. The other heads into a flavoring drum. The drum revolves to gently toss the cereal as a sprayer applies a granola kind of flavoring. The other stream of wheat and corn flakes enters the sugar coating drum. A sprayer disperses a sugar and water mixture as the drum tosses the flakes. Then they travel through a dryer, and this cures the frosting to the flakes. The frosted and the flavored flakes now flow onto the same conveyor. It bounces the flakes around to blend them together. To boost the nutrition content, they add honey-flavored granola. The granola clusters flow onto a conveyor. They'll merge with the frosted and flavored flakes. This feeder pipe showers granola onto the flakes. This frosted cereal is now ready for supermarket shelves. Machinery dispenses specific amounts into a plastic sleeve, which is heat sealed, then severed at both ends. Mechanical arms then pick up boxes, open them, and place them on a conveyor. Push rods guide the bags of cereal into the boxes. The best before date and other information have been printed on the outside. Nozzles apply glue to the ends, and the boxes brush by a side barrier that closes them. Producing and packaging this frosted cereal blend has taken about 5 hours. Now people can wake up to their first meal of the day knowing how it's made.
Waffles
started out in the Middle Ages as a flat wafer made not from wheat flour, but from oats or barley. As its popularity spread, many variations of shape and recipe developed. the introduction of leavening ingredients gave rise to the waffle as we know it today. It's enjoyed across Europe as a type of cake, but in America, they have them for breakfast. The introduction of frozen waffles in the 1950s marked the dawn of a new era for those that liked eating them, but not cooking them. Knocking up a plate of waffles was suddenly a snap. All the main preparation work takes place at the factory. They add flavorings like berries to a flour-based waffle mix, and then turn to liquid ingredients, water, canola oil, and liquid cane sugar. They pour them into a big tank and mix thoroughly. They're then ready to thicken it into a batter with the flour-based waffle premix. It also includes baking powder, which reacts with water to cause pockets of carbon dioxide to form for a leavening effect that will continue during baking. After adding more berries, this batter is complete, and there's enough in this one tank to produce 3,600 waffles. Hot waffle irons are sprayed with a mist of non-stick coating. Down the line, an automated pump deposits measured amounts of batter onto each grid plate. The top grid plates encase the batter. This production line is computerized, which ensures the plates are filled quickly and without any spills. As they move towards the oven, the waffle irons rotate, allowing the batter to reach all the crevices inside. They now move through a long gas oven. It takes about 2 minutes for them to cook. They emerge from the oven piping hot, where a machine called a picking drum removes them from the irons. As the picking drum revolves, needles grab the waffles and pull them off the hot grid plates. The picking drum transports the waffles up to another level. The needles retract, transferring them to a series of conveyors. At the other side of the factory, the waffles enter a blast freezer. The temperature inside is minus 7 degrees Celsius. Fans blow frigid air onto the waffles as they spiral through the freezer. It takes just 20 minutes to freeze and preserve these freshly baked waffles. The frozen waffles now merge into lanes to be sorted for stacking. A trapdoor system releases them, three at a time, to grippers that move them onto a conveyor. The conveyor lane narrows, which forces the waffle stacks into a single row. A sensor-activated gate releases the stacks two at a time to the packing station. It takes just a second for the two stacks of frozen waffles to be wrapped and sealed in a tight cellophane packet. Then it's into a metal detector. To demonstrate how it works, a coin was placed on one of the packages. The system senses it immediately, and a blower blasts the package off the conveyor. Suctioning fingers now pick up the outer box and open it as they place it on the conveyor. A ram shoves the waffles into the box.